Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about late blight of potato. Late blight of potato, it was responsible for Irish potato famine in the mid 19th century. In the late 20th century, there have been major reoccurrence around the world over this pathogen and its disease due to recent mutation. Symptoms. It first appeared as water-soaked spots, usually at the tips or edge of lower leaves where water or dew tends to collect. Under moist, cold, cool condition, water-soaked spots rapidly enlarge and a broad yellow halo may be seen surrounding the lesion. On the leaf underside, a spore-producing zone of white moldy growth approximately 0.1 to 0.2 inches wide may appear at the border of the lesion. Under continuous wet condition, the disease progresses rapidly and warm, dry weather will slow or stop disease development. As the condition become moist and cool, disease development resumes. Tuber lesion first appear as irregular, dark blotch. When cut open, affected tissue is water-soaked, reddish-brown and extend with an irregular margin into the tuber flesh. Lesion may start as superficial decay that continue to develop after tubers are harvested and placed into storage. Old lesion may become firm and sunken due to water loss and tubers will appear shrunken. Infected tubers are commonly invaded by secondary decay organisms such as soft rot bacteria and therefore are quite likely to decay during storage. The pathogen which causes late blight of potato is Phytophthora infestans. This pathogen will not survive in Indian plain due to high temperature. Primary source of inoculum is seeds which are stored in case of hill plant debris. Collateral hosts are Solanum nigrum, Datura, Stromanium. Coming to the systemic position, the kingdom Mycota, division Eumycota, subdivision Mastigomycotina, class Eumycetes, order Pernosporales, family Pythiaceae, genus Phytophthora, species Infestans. Coming to the life cycle of this pathogen, the pathogen produces sporangia on the diseased seedling and leaf. Zoospores are produced and released from the sporangia. Zoospores affect the leaves. Then these zoospores infect the tubers also. Seedling produced by infected tubers become diseased. Lesion and fungus development on the leaves. Then the sporangia are formed on the seedling and leaves are dispersed to healthy leaves. This is the life cycle of this pathogen. Now, what are the factors responsible for epidemic? Temperature of night time, if it is below dew point for more than 4 hours, it will cause this epidemic, or even minimum temperature of 10 degrees centigrade or coldness, rain for 24 hours at least 0.1 millimeter will cause the epidemic of this plant pathogen. Coming to the disease management, use healthy seeds, removal of plant debris, removal of weeds, harvesting in dry season, harvesting after ripening, remove upper portion before 15 days of harvesting, earthening of 10 to 15 cm, balanced fertilization of nitrogen and proper irrigation, seed treatment, rhizomyle 5% dust where 1 kg per 100 kg seeds are used, storage at 3.5 to 4.4 degree centigrade, spray mancozeb, dithane, Z 78 for 2.5 kg hectare, kg per hectare, and use resistant variety like Kufri, Basha कुफरी अलंकार, कुफरी स्वर्ण और कुफरी जीवन और कुफरी ज्योति एक्सेट्रा.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.